If you want to work out the number of working days between two dates, Excel has got two functions that does it. In the more recent versions of Excel, there's a more updated version, which is the one we're going to use. And you'll see if you go in and start typing, it's called network days. And you'll notice there's two options. We're going to go for the second one called network days international. And then it's just a case of following the prompts. So it's asking you, when is the start date? I'm going to point over here. I'm going to put a comma. Where's the end date? And when I put another comma, you'll notice it asks us what is a weekend, because a weekend, depending where you are and what industry you're in, weekends can be different. So is a weekend your Saturday and Sunday? Or is it maybe a Friday, Saturday? Or if you're in an industry where your off days are actually Monday, so a restaurant, hairdressers, etc., you can choose any one of those. So I'm going to stick with Saturday, Sunday. I'm going to click tab and push a comma. Then asks, are there any holidays, public holidays, those type of things. We've got a nice list here. I'm going to highlight it. Push F4 to get the dollar signs everywhere. When I close it and click enter, it'll tell me how many working days there are. When I copy down, you'll see it gives us the calculation. It will take into account if any of these days are Saturdays and Sundays. It'll also exclude the public holidays. Just be careful again with the way Excel works with dates. You may need to just see what these dates mean and whether you need to add or subtract a date, simply because the way Excel works is it treats a day from the beginning of the day to the beginning of the day, whereas humans tend to treat that as that whole day plus that whole day.